Hello everyone. So today I'm going to be trying to explain how to read a wiring diagram for a lawn tractor. Now obviously there is a lot of lawn tractors out there and they all have their own different electrical wiring systems, but I've chosen my favourite, which is Westwood, not only because they're fairly simple when it comes to wiring, but because their wiring diagrams are laid out in such a simple way. Now, if you look at it to begin with, it can actually look pretty daunting, but believe me, it's not as bad as it looks. Okay, so this is actually the PCB which goes with this wiring diagram. So I'm going to try and explain this as simply as I can. You'll see there are a load of numbers down here, and it goes from 1 to 13. This specific machine actually only goes up to 12, the 13 is there as an extra. Now each of those numbers is a different pin on here, and each pin goes through a different circuit on the back of here. And you might be able to see the different circuits going from each pin, and they all have their own different jobs. So let's take number one for example. Number one, the wire which comes out of number one, which is this one at the end here, that goes straight to ground. Because if we follow this back, it says black, and that's the black wire, and the earth symbol is there. That is those three or four little lines in a triangle shape, and that is earth. Now if we follow that through the actual circuit board itself, it goes up here, over the top, down the side, and it comes over the top here, and it's actually providing the earth for all of these LEDs which are being displayed on the dashboard as well. So number one really is the earth. All of the others go somewhere in the machine. So everything this side of this dotted line, they're physical wires. Everything within here is that circuit board. So we've got our two relays here, and these are the two symbols for that. We've also got three fuses. We've got a 3 amp, a 6 amp, and another 3 amp. That is these three here. The one on the end, you might be able to read that there, is a spare. So if any of these blow, you've got one here. Okay, so we're now going to move away from the printed circuit board side of things, because everything in here makes it look a lot more complicated than it is. But like I say, each of these lines is actually within the circuit board itself. So they're not actually physical wires. Outside of here, all of these are wires within the wiring loom which go with the lawn tractor. So just here we've got a circle with numbers 1 to 5 in, and this is our ignition barrel. In the diagram we've actually got a square which represents the ignition barrel. And this is showing each wire which runs to it, where each wire goes to, and where the earth is, and where the switches are. But just to keep it simple, they have basically put a circle there, because that's what the real ignition barrel looks like, with the five terminals on. So obviously this is an ignition barrel from a lawnmower, and we've got our five terminals, and that's what they've numbered here. But to obviously make it simpler in the wiring diagram, it's a square, but they have matched up the numbers with the numbers in the circle. So you can actually put each number here with each number on here. Okay, so let's look at the starter solenoid. So we've got our main red cable coming out of the battery and to the starter solenoid. Now the starter solenoid is basically a giant switch. It needs something to trigger it for it to pass the energy from here to here. Then we have our trigger wire. This is what will allow that wire there to connect to that wire there. We also have our ground on the solenoid just there. So how do we connect to that wire to that wire? Well, basically, like I say, this is our wire here, and if we follow it all the way back, we will get to number three, which is the green wire. If this is followed through the circuit board, you'll see it goes through the relays, and then it comes through to the orange, and then we get to our ignition switch. So basically, when we turn the ignition switch, we are connecting two wires together, and that is what is then sending the electricity through this wire and then connecting that wire to that wire. When the power is transmitted through this wire, it connects these two together, jumps up inside, and then it joins this side, and it can then transfer the power through. Now I'll get into how a starter solenoid works in another video, but essentially it is just a giant switch, and when the power is applied here, it can then connect this wire to this wire by electrically charging inside the solenoid. So we'll now look at the alternator and see how this gets the power from the engine here actually back to the battery. So it really is a case of just following wires all the time. If we follow alternator 1 up through the wires, you see it's a red wire, so that's what you'd look for if you're looking for the alternator's wire. It goes into number 6 on the printed circuit board. So if we look at the printed circuit board, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this one here is our charge one. You will then see that it goes through a fuse, it comes down, it tells the charge LED whether it's charging or not, and obviously that LED goes to earth. It then goes through here, goes through a diode, comes out, and then it's the pink wire. If we follow the pink all the way through, you'll see that it comes back to a 10 amp fuse and to the battery. So that is how our power gets from the alternator to the battery. Now on some, they'll go from the alternator to a regulator or rectifier, and this will basically convert it from AC to DC, and the power will still then be transmitted through the wiring loom, and it will eventually come back to the battery. So everything is fairly similar here. We can trace anything back because it's obviously one complete circuit. We've also got two breaks in the circuit here. We've got safe cutter switch and we've got safe brake switch. And if you were to try and start the engine with the brake off, basically nothing will happen because we've got this brake in the circuit. This is a sensor which is attached to the brake itself, and when you put your foot on that brake, what you're also doing, you will not know it probably at the time, but you're also connecting two wires together. And the way you're doing that is two sensors. Now usually when you push your foot on the pedal, you're also pushing like a little plunger which is connecting a circuit together. So say this is our wire here and here. When you push your foot on the pedal, your plunger is touching the two wires and joining the two together. Now this will vary on all the different lawn tractors there are out there. Lots of different designs, lots of different ways of doing the safe switches, but they're all the same general idea. So yeah, I can keep going on for hours telling you all the different things, but really anything can be traced back. It's fairly simple to work out everything. You've got your normal ground symbols just here. You've got your relays which are here, and your resistors which are here. You've got your fuses which are there, and they also tell you how many amps each one is. So if you ever needed to replace one, if you had your printed circuit board, this one had gone, you didn't know how many amps to put in, refer to this, 6 amps. It's very simple. So, yeah, like I say, I can keep going on for hours, but I don't think it'd be worth it. Again, you've got your inline fuses. This one here is a fuse. It's fuse 4, but it's not the same as these fuses. These fuses are actually soldered into the circuit board. This one will be a plastic fuse holder, and it will come apart, it will split in half in the middle. You'll be able to take the fuse out, and you can put your new one in, and that's how you replace those fuses. And like I say, that is the charging fuse. So if you ever don't have any charge, but your alternator is working, check that fuse, because that is probably what's gone. I don't think there's a great deal more to say. But really, these switches, they're remarkably simple. All you're doing when you're flicking the switch to turn the lights on is just joining them together. Now, it might sound obvious, but some people won't understand that. Really, these lawn tractors, the wiring isn't that complicated. Now, I know that the newer ones are becoming a lot more advanced, and yes, they are getting a lot more complicated. So those wiring diagrams will be harder, I have to admit. But the majority of the 80s, 90s machines will be relatively simple. Now, this one is actually for a Tecumseh and a Briggs & Stratton engine, manufactured between about 1983 and 1990. 1999, I think. So almost 20 years there. Well, 15 years. But yeah, they have changed. They are a bit more complicated, but the design and the idea is still very similar. So yeah, that is how you read a wiring diagram on a lawn tractor. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in my next video.